So I have an update on my Club Royale offers drying up, and I'm gonna share them with you now. Hey, what's up? My name is Chris Fantini, and my channel is all about getting you on the biggest ships in the world for free just by spending some time at the casino. In my last video, I was talking about how for the first time in over 2 years, I had zero free cruises in my Club Royale queue online at clubroyaleoffers.com. I was shocked because I always had multiple offers, like 3, 4, 5 free cruises just sitting there waiting for me to use. And it wasn't because I wasn't gambling on cruises. My last cruise on Grandeur of the Seas a few weeks ago, I did really well. I spent a lot of time in the casino. I earned 1,200 points and a instant certificate. So I fully expected to see more offers flowing in. And no, there were none. And I thought, did they change stuff? Are they making it so that you're not going to get free offers anymore? Did they up the amount of time you needed to spend in the casino or points you needed to earn to get those free offers? The hilarious thing is, the moment that I posted that video last week, I went out to my mailbox and lo and behold, I got this. It was really strange too, because I do get these cards from time to time in the snail mail, but I usually get them after they've already appeared on the clubroyaleoffers.com website. And I went on and I looked and there was still nothing in that queue. So I thought maybe something was broken. I wasn't really sure what was happening. I put a ticket in with the Club Royale offers team. And then the next day, poof, the offer did appear in my clubroyaleoffers.com queue. So this is kind of good news. I've got an offer. I'm really excited about that. There's some pretty good ones to choose from there, but still it's a lot less than what I'm used to. So I did a little bit of digging. I posted on a Facebook group. I asked around on Reddit to see kind of what other people were experiencing. And of course, I asked you guys in the comments and I got a lot of great responses. People are still getting offers online. They're still getting the offers in the snail mail. So they may be a bit higher rollers than me, spend more time, spend more money in the casino. So what I'm gonna tell you next is kind of like a theory from what I've heard from other people and what I've experienced myself. So please don't take it as gospel. It's just what I think is happening. So the first thing I think is happening is that Royal Caribbean is experiencing record high bookings. They're doing really well across all their ships. Their ships are filling up, even with the increase in fare costs boosting all around, not just with Royal Caribbean, but with all cruise lines. They're still doing a really good job booking these cabins. So they probably don't need to offer quite as many comps in the casino to get people on the ships and in the casino gambling. So what I think is happening is they may have raised their bar for Theo. If you don't know what Theo is, it's the theoretical expected losses. And that's not necessarily just the money you spend in the casino, but it's also the time you spend. They have an algorithm, which, you know, I'm not privy to. I think it's very secret, where they calculate how much money you spend, how much time you spend, what are your habits in the casino? And that is a theoretical calculation. I think they may have raised the bar on what the Theo is that allows you to receive offers. Part two, very interestingly, is Club Royale has reintroduced the 800 point instant certificate. So if you don't know what instant certificates are, if you earn a certain level of points on a single individual cruise, you will be offered a list of cruises for free that you can choose from. You go down to the next cruise booth and then you put down a deposit. You don't even have to book a specific cruise. You put a deposit down and then you have a certain amount of time to pick your cruise, pay for it, and you get a free cruise. And it could be anything from, you know, an interior on some, you know, select sailings to like balconies and suites, depending on if you're a high roller. But that is basically how instant certificates work. Now, for the longest time, $1,200 was the first level of instant certificate. Then it went to $1,500 and then up from there, and you could, you know, go on for a long time. What they've done is they have reintroduced an 800 point certificate. So what that means is that inventory is coming from somewhere, right? A lot more people are gonna earn 800 points than maybe have hit the 1200 point level. I think what they're trying to do is they're trying to encourage in-cruise gambling. So not just spending more time in the casino with the Theo, but also, you know, really cycling money through, being at table games, earning points, trying to get people to at least get that 800 point level to get a free cruise. So I think some of their comp inventory that they were dedicating to email offers, they have pushed over into this 800 point certificate. So this is all really interesting. Again, this is not like confirmed, fully vetted information. This is basically a theory that I've devised off of all the people I've talked to and everything I've seen online. What is your experience? Do you agree with me? Do you think I'm kind of right in my thinking? Do you think I'm wrong? Do you have any information that might make me rethink this? Let me know in the comments. Also, of course, I'm going to be cruising here in just over a month on the gorgeous brand new Utopia of the Seas. It's a 4-night cruise. I am going to gamble as I normally do. I'm likely gonna earn an instant certificate on that cruise. I should generally make 800 points depending on how the cruise goes, but we'll see if I get more email offers based off of that cruise as well. And of course, I'm gonna make some videos on, you know, what the casino looks like, what games are available, what games I play, how long I spend in the casino, how much money I spend, and of course, how many points I earn. So stay tuned for those. Of course, make sure you have the notifications on and subscribe so that you're notified when those videos come out. All right, so moving on to Royal Caribbean's sister line, Celebrity Cruises. There is a bit of a poop storm brewing when it comes to their blue chip casino loyalty program. So I'm gonna start by saying I've never cruised on Celebrity, so I don't have any personal experience with this. This is just what I'm hearing from friends who do cruise on Celebrity and things that I'm seeing online. But the blue chip casino program is significantly different than most other casino programs. It's pretty generous, but you also have to spend quite a bit more money in order to earn the perks for the blue chip program. So some of the things that you get with blue chip that you're not getting with a lot of the other casino programs is you get free play for every cruise 4 nights or over based on your level. So you can be like Sapphire, Sapphire Plus, or Ruby. Those are the ones that are unlocked there. And you can get anything from 500 per cruise all the way up to like 1500 or more, I think. This is for every cruise that you book. And it's different from Club Royale and other ones where they kind of give you your free play as you earn points during a cruise and then you lose them at the end if you don't spend them. So not only that, but you get other perks like free Wi-Fi, you get free gratuities, and you also get free drink packages if you're at one of the higher levels. So what Celebrity is doing now is they are consolidating their casino loyalty programs, Club Royale and the Blue Chip, on Celebrity. Now, they're not, you know, making them the same name or anything like that, but they are doing a lot of the back infrastructure. They're combining the teams, and then they're also aligning the two programs to be similar to one another. So what does all this mean for blue chippers? So the blue chip year of earning points ends on July 31st, and then we start another year of rewards. You get your status, and you get all those rewards that your status entails. Well, Celebrity just shocked everybody by unveiling a whole new reward system that is a lot less valuable than the one that they had previously. They eliminated stuff like that free play for every cruise 4 nights and more from $500 up to $1,500. And they transitioned to the Club Royale style where you earn points and during that cruise, you can spend the accrued points in free play. Additionally, they removed the free gratuities at the certain level. And they also removed the free drinks package at a certain level. And they replaced these with more Club Royale style rewards, such as like discounts in the jewelry shop, discounts at the spa, things like that, that are a lot less valuable. So blue chippers are angry because they're losing all these really great perks and they didn't know that when they were earning last year. So they did a really significant investment and they're not getting the rewards. Enough people did complain that I love the fact that Royal Caribbean and Celebrity said, okay, we made a mistake. We're gonna roll back some of these changes for these years. But there is a proviso. The benefits that they rolled back, like the free play and the drink package and stuff like that, are only valid on cruises that are booked by August 1st of this year and cruises that are taken by July 31st of 2025. So if you're a blue chipper and you earned your status for this year, Make sure you book all of your cruises before August 1st and make sure you take them before July 31st. The one little interesting side note about this is I could never get a comp from Celebrity. That's why I have not participated or ever sailed on Celebrity. But I think these changes are gonna cause several of their blue chippers to look for other opportunities to cruise either on Royal Caribbean or maybe even on like Carnival or Princess, because Princess especially has got some really great perks. What that might mean is Celebrity might want to start enticing more people to come to their ships and onto their casinos, which might mean if I try again, I might get a comp from Celebrity, which I'm really excited about. I'll let you know how that goes. So that's it for this one. I am really excited for Utopia of the Seas on August 23rd. I hope you'll like, subscribe, put your notification bell on, so once those videos on Utopia start coming out, you'll know. Thanks for watching.